Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In the previous two videos, I introduced the new Discovery Connector nodes that were added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.5. I'd earlier created a message flow to create a bucket in Amazon S3 and another flow to create an item in the bucket. In this video, I'll show how you can retrieve data from Amazon S3 and show how you can set filter options. I have one item in the bucket, which is called TestObject1, and I'll retrieve this item, and the contents of that item will be shown in the message flow. So I will create a new message flow, and I will call it RetrieveItem. And in this flow, I'll actually use two Amazon S3 request nodes. The first node will be used to get the object metadata. So I already have a policy project, which I used in the previous videos. This contains a policy which has a reference to the credentials that are needed to connect to Amazon S3. So I will select the option to retrieve object metadata, and I will select the bucket, which is Ace Sanjay bucket. I'll specify a filter option, and I'll specify a prefix. I'll just specify T, and I'll specify that just one item should be retrieved. So I've saved the configuration, and I can now see the options on the node. So I can see I have selected the action to retrieve the object metadata, and I've specified the prefix and filter limit. I can edit the prefix, I can specify different values, so I'll change it to test, click OK, and save that. Now select another request node, and I'll launch the connected discovery wizard again. I'll use the same policy to connect to Amazon S3, and this time I'm going to select the action to retrieve the object contents. So I'll select show more actions and specify the action retrieve object content. Specify the bucket which contains the item and click save. So schemas have been downloaded for both nodes. For the first node, it has downloaded a response schema. And for the second request node, it has downloaded a request and response schema. For the second request node, you can see it has the option to retrieve object content, and there are no filter options for this. However, you do need to specify the key for the item as input to this node. So to do that, I'm going to use a mapping node. And I'm going to specify the response schema from the first request node. And I'm going to specify the request schema of the second request node. And I can see that the key is provided in the response. So I'll map that so that it can be used in the input tree to the second request node. So I'll just add HTTP input and reply node to drive the flow. And specify a URL path suffix to use on the HTTP input node. And specify the input message parsing to use for JSON message domain. We'll also add HTTP reply node to catch any exception that may occur. Okay, I'll start the test server. So the test server has started, and now I can put a message through the flow. So I can see that the content has been retrieved from Amazon. Let's have a look at the message tree after the first request node. So I can see the metadata that was sent back after the first request node. Look at the input message tree to the second request node. You can see that the key was specified. And if we have a look at the message tree after the second request node, we can see the content that was retrieved. So in this video, I've shown how to retrieve content data from an item in an Amazon S3 bucket. I've shown how to specify filter options and that they can be modified on the node. In this scenario, an input field had to be specified to the second request node, and this was done using a mapping node and using the schemas that were downloaded using the Connector Discovery Wizard.